Hello friends, my name is Shivam from DevOps Schools and I will help you to enable your learning process in various technologies of DevOps, artificial intelligence, machine learning, big data and many more. This is our initiative to help you by sharing multiple tutorials and videos. And if you want any specific tutorials on any particular topic, then please do comment in the below comment section and I will help you with it. Also, please subscribe to our premium services on YouTube, which will give you access to more content and videos to enhance your knowledge about all these topics. Also, if you want me to help you with regards to the online trainings and classroom sessions by our qualified trainers, then please write me at contact@devopschool.com. Thank you.
Okay, so it's a very important session, guys. It's a very important, so please focus. Now, then unfortunate things, like many things we will not be able to repeat back in tomorrow session, so because we have to always move on. So just focus on this. So I think I had an architecture in Kubernetes. So we had a master, right? And then we had a worker, correct? Worker. And then we had a workstation, correct? Workstation. Now, in the master, which are the components? Any idea? I think I forgot. Can you help me? What were the components?
API server.
First, API server, yes. What else?
Cluster store.
Cluster store.
Controller.
Yeah. And third, controller manager.
Schedule.
S-C-H-E-D-U-L-E. Yeah. So now this is the master component. Okay, now in this we have worker component also. In the worker component we have which are those? Can you help me?
Kubelet.
Kubeproxy.
And second one, Docker engine, right? Container engine.
Docker.
And then Kubeproxy.
Kubeproxy.
Correct, yeah. Now in the workstation, what we have? In the workstation?
Kubectl.
Kubectl. Correct. Kubectl. Right? Yeah. Good. Now guys, see what is happening here. Kubernetes says run your application in pod. Kubernetes says run your application in pod. So can't we? So if they are giving suggestion to us, like run your application in a pod, if pod has a container, containers come from the images, this, that and all stuff like that. So should not they also follow the same thing? They should follow the same thing, no? Same structure. So guys, API server is one application. So when it is application, they are asking me to and you to run application in the pod and container. So they should also run in the pod. Correct, na? So guys, they are running in the pod. These all are applications is running in the pod. Now, I think I forgot who creates a pod. Anyone remember? Who creates pod?
Kubelet.
So guys, if this is the pod, so don't you think the kubelet should be there in the master also? Right? Logic, as per the logic, kubelet only can create a pod. So kubelet should be there in the master, because these all are pod. Now guys, pod has a container. So container created by whom? Any idea? Docker, yes. So Docker has to be there. Now container, pod get IP address, networking services. So then come from where? Come from where?
Proxy.
Yeah, Kubeproxy. Yeah.
Kubeproxy.
So guys, yes, true. I've been teaching you this one, you'll be no worker, but actually master is also having there one worker. Master is also can work like a worker. So master has a kubelet, Docker, Kubeproxy, which is similar to this one. Out of which, containers come from the Docker image. Okay. Image. And image comes from the, Google registry. Yeah, they are not using Hub actually. Docker Hub. They are using Google registry. So if I go there, this is the right one. Okay. And kubeproxy is one application. Docker and kubelet cannot be application because this is an agent. Each node has to run it. And this is the engine. It required the access to the kernel and all. So it cannot be. So these are the daemon mode which is running as. So guys, did you understand this anatomy? Master?
Rajesh, can you repeat that this running as a daemon something you told?
So Docker is a Docker engine which is basically running as a daemon. That means Docker need to communicate with, think about logically, Docker, I'll put it in an image first because sometimes even I get confused. Okay, so its image is very simple. So here, think about it, this is a node, okay? And the node, you have a pod. Pod created by which one? Kubelet. Now inside the pod, there is a container. Container created by Docker. So at any cost, this guy and this guy cannot be a pod, right? Because if this guy can be a pod, who will create a container and pod? Are you understanding now? Right? Hello?
Yeah.
So now this Docker is running as a daemon. Yes. Kubelet is also running as a daemon. Now Docker talk to the kernel, okay? And kubelet is running as a daemon and the host machine only. So how it talk to the kernel and run, please watch my Docker videos. Probably it will help you. Okay? Got it? Okay, so guys, let's move on. So guys, you know one thing? This is called single node cluster. So single node cluster. When you have a worker and master together, okay, this is called single node cluster. Now this is basically you will create for learning purpose. So how can we create a single node cluster? Very easy way. So there is one utility which is called Minikube. Some of you have tried actually, I guess. Okay, Minikube. Minikube is nothing but one exe is there. See, I'll just tell you the flow. This Minikube is a exe which requires, which will do create, download the ISO, bigger single node cluster. Single node. Is it? Everyone? Guys, can you not see my screen?
Yeah, lost the share.
Oh. What about now?
We can see now.
Okay. So here, single node cluster, which is a Minikube. It's a download. Whenever you run this Minikube start command, this will download the one ISO, create a VM. This for VM creation, you need a VirtualBox. Or Hyper-V also it supported. So, VMware also nowadays is supported, I guess. So like this. Run a VM, configure a single node cluster. That's all. Use it. Single node cluster for the running purpose. But you know one thing? You don't want to set up a single node cluster. You want to set up a manual way. Manual way, you can set up in the physical machine. Physical machine, okay, or virtual machines, manual way, VMs, but what? Using kubeadm, okay, using kubeadm, manual way, physical machines, VM using kubeadm, okay, so this is the kubeadm, got it guys? But you know one thing, you want to set up on the cloud and integrate with cloud such as AWS, GC. I don't know the Azure support has come or not, and vSphere and all stuff like that. So if you want to set up on the cloud and integrate with the cloud services, then you should use COPS. Okay, I don't know what is happening actually, because why it's getting automatically broken, not sure. Now, and I think recording is getting stopped up. No, recording is not getting stopped, but screen is getting automatically paused. Why? Paused or stopped? Now you are able to see?
Now it can be. Yes.
Not sure what is happening. Okay. So these are the ways. So if you set up a manual way, this is the way. On the cloud, this is the way. What's the solution? This is the way. Make sense, guys? Any questions? EKS, we call it Elastic.
No, AKS, the second one.
AKS. Okay, it's on Azure Kubernetes service. So you don't have to set up a cluster. They will manage a cluster for you. Something like EKS, AKS on Azure, GK on Google Cloud. Got it?
Yeah, got it.
Okay. So, guys, this is the solution. Out of which, I will try manual way, we will try manual way, but if you have any other suggestion, we can try. So which one you are looking for it?
Manual way.
Manual way,
manual
it'll be good.
Way is better actually. We will be able to set up a cluster.
Yes. Even I'm teaching manual way all the time, but yes, these are the cloud based, you won't set up anything. Everything will be done by them. Okay, so yeah, so guys, this is the one. By the way, each of these products is a free and open source. COPS is open source, Kubedium is open source, Minikube is open source, so all this thing you can use it. So we'll set up a manual way, which is using Kubedium. Okay, so now let's get it set up this here. So I'll go for Amazon and here, and guys, request you to all to focus on this screen, because I'm going to give you the lab which I'll be doing it, so you have to do the same thing. So if you do not focus, you get stuck, then you'll have a trouble, you know, because each and every topic is dependent on other topic, so like that. Okay, so what I'm doing right now, I'm setting up the manual way. So I'll go for and create one machine in front of you on AWS. CentOS. Two CPU, 4 GB RAM, one machine, storage 30 GB is sufficient for this demo. Here, name, master, but this is my master, right? Rajesh, I'll name it Rajesh. And launch configuration here. Default, review, launch.
Rajesh Mumbai. This is the IP address. I'll give you your own IP address during the lab. So you have to see me doing it very well. Username is CentOS and password I'll give it to you. Key PPK file. Okay, I'll give it to you. And like that. So now let me log in. Now here auth ppk so it should come. Restarted the session. Yes, CentOS sudo hyphen s. Okay. Colors, appearance, 16. Click OK. Apply. Can you see, guys, can you see my screen? All of you?
Not yet.
Okay.
Not yet,
no. No, Rajesh.
Yeah, yeah. Now, what about now?
Yeah, you can see it now.
Okay. Sorry, guys, I think I got disconnected with the broadband. So I have to connect that my data, mobile data. Okay, so now I have to log in as a CentOS and I'll become a root, sudo hyphen s. Okay, now how can we install this manual way? So for that I have created one document. So first thing, you have to install Docker and then some other utility. So which are the utility you need? Docker you need, Kubeadium you need, kubectl you need, Kubelet you need, all this thing you need it, kubectl, kubelet, all this thing you need it here. Okay, so Docker, Kubeadium, kubectl, kubelet, all this thing you need it. So for that, here I'll go to my notes and access it. And here I'll type kubeadium. Okay. Now I'll just go through that and I found out setting up Kubernetes cluster using kubeadium manual way. And this is the URL I'm putting up in the notes. So you'll also follow this. So this document has all the required prerequisite crisp information to set up it. So this is the goal. This is the meaning of it. Some of the prerequisite what you can read it. And Docker is needed. So from where you get a Docker? This is the Docker. Guys, can you hear me? Hello?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes, we can hear you.
Yeah, so you have to install the Docker. This is the Docker installation documents. So before that, you have to install Docker. Now here, this is for removing Docker, okay? So understand that. So you have to install this one through this. Okay, so this is the machine which I am having, and this is the instruction. So I am following this one. Sudo and enter. And here, and here, this is the Docker installation. Some most of you have done it, but just a fine tune information, so you don't have to run around here and there. Install it. Okay, now enable this Docker and start the Docker services. Okay, so now here Docker info, you got this. Okay, so this is the Docker installation done. So guys, you have any doubts of my steps? Any questions, any doubts? Guys, are you there? Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear.
Okay. So, will you be able to do that? Docker installation? Any questions?
No questions.
Okay. Now, after that, I'll install the KubeATM. So, guys, this instruction is here in this page. I'm giving you that. So which are the utility I need to install? KubeATM, Kubelet, kubectl, Docker and CNI. So these are the things we need to install it. Now guys, let me tell you, all this is a different product. You must read it. Okay. Here. I will let you allow to read it a little bit later because I want to set up my cluster as soon as possible. So I'll let you this reading yourself only. This one liner explanation is more than sufficient. And now step 1, step 2, step 3 and step 4, you should not do that. So why? Because this you can do in the virtual machine. I am using AWS. Do not do step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4. Okay. So these are the step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4. Okay. So this is the things which we have. You should not do that. Why? Because for the VMs in AWS, these are the changes already done. Continue from step 5. Okay, continue from step 5. This is the one. Okay, continue from step 5. So here what we have, clear the screen. So I am doing this one. So copy from here. Don't copy blindly. Look at this, what I am copying. This will add a repository. What repository? Yum repository. So after adding this, you get all these tools, you know, all these tools in one repository. Okay, and after that set enforce 0, done. After this replace this one to set permissive, enforcing to permissive make it, done. And after that you have to install, see here, install all these utilities. And now installing kubeadium, kubelet, kubectl, CNIS, and everything is being installed in this command. Okay. Now, after that, you have to enable the kubelet. Done. So, kubelet is also done, guys. Now, guys, if you want to see here, initialize a Kubernetes cluster master. So, you have to run this command, kubeinit init. Remember, init you have to run only one time. Again, I am repeating, init only you have to run one time in a server where you want to set up a master. Okay, init is initializing the new cluster all the time. So, you have to be mindful about it. Okay, so can I run it now? Clear the screen. And I'm running right now. Taking few seconds. Okay guys, can you please read this here? Your Kubernetes control plane has initialized successfully, and then you have this one. So guys, one more thing, if you do not copy this one, then you will waste lots of time because I need to reset your server remote. So this is, I am copying in this note, but do not you will get it, you have your own copy of it. Okay. So guys, your cluster is set up successfully. And do not forget to copy this. Guys, did you understand this, all of you? How do you set up a cluster? Any confusion, any questions? Done. Output step now 9 is done. So, any question? Hello?
No.
Okay, great. So now if you do not have any questions, let me set up next one. So this is the master setup is done. Now master setup is done. Now what you have to set it up? You have to set up a workstation. Set up workstation. Now, let's understand first and then we'll set it up. Setup is just a matter of 1 minute, understanding is a little tricky. So, guys, this is my master machine. This is my master machine. And this is my laptop workstation. And this is another machine. Okay, just a second. This is another machine. In the network, you will have so many machines. So in the workstation, what we install, any idea? In the workstation, what we installed?
Kubectl.
Kubectl. So guys, we installed the kubectl. And master is running here. Master, do you have API server, cluster store etcd, controller manager and scheduler. Okay. Now the question is, kubectl is here.
To get our channel membership, click on to the join button, select the 3D99 plan and grow your skills immensely.
API server is here. So kubectl should talk to this machine or this machine or this machine. How do you know? How this kubectl will know which machine is having the master? And that is the question. You do understand that problem? Everyone? How this kubectl will know which is a master, which machine? Because in a cluster you have hundreds of machines. So which machine is master and which machine is not master? How do you know? So anyone has got this idea? Any clue? Any suggestion? No. Etcd is a database, no? That's a sort of database. That's my thing is kubectl, how kubectl will know which is the API server? That's a question. I heard some of you have tried Minikube. That's the reason I'm asking. Because most of you might have not tried, but some of you have tried. So guys, kubeconfig. What is this kubeconfig? So we need to understand this. So here what happened? There is one utility which is called kubectl. Where it's located? In workstation. Kubectl read the three location by default. Which are those? Current location. Okay. Current location. And slash dot kube. Okay. That's a. Or user home location. And then dot kube. Okay. Current location and user home location dot kube. Or they read the environment variable. That's called kubeconfig. Okay. Kubeconfig. Okay. So this is the three places they look for it. And then read the directory. In two places, they read the dot kube directory. In the current location, user home location. Or kubeconfig, it can be anywhere. Now inside that there is a file which is called config file. There is a file which is called config file. And this is a file, it can be any location. So any location. And here it can be config file. So here kubectl to know where is the API server. See that here. To this one, they read their config file. Config file. This is the config file. Which are those location? This one. That is the reason you see we call it kubeconfig together. What we call it? Kubeconfig. Basically the file name is config, but we call it kubeconfig. So guys, did you understand that?
Yes.
Yeah. Now, guys, what happens in this file? What is the content we need to understand? So this is the content I am talking about. The config file content I am talking about. Please understand it very carefully. In config file, what happens, you know, maybe you are the guy, you are admin of three cluster. So now let's have this cluster also, this cluster also, this master also, this master also, this master also. That means you have a three cluster. You are managing three cluster. One is a dev cluster, one is a QA cluster, and one is a production cluster. Typical scenarios. That means you have to work with the three cluster. That means three entries, that means three user ID, that means three API servers, three different cluster. So how do you manage those complexities? So one of the things what you can do, you can have a config file, config-dev, config-QA, config-this, but it's like a not a good way. I mean, it's like you are doing versioning like a V1, V2, V3, V5, V4, it's not like that. Use the Git, no, Git is for the versioning, something like that. So can we do one thing? Can we in a file only? Can we manage everything? Can we manage everything in one config file only? That means whether you have a 3 cluster, 5 cluster, 20 cluster, if you are working with it, can you insert it over the data in the config itself? So that I am trying to do with you right now. So see here, considering there's a multi-cluster nodes. So what I have to do? you have to how to log in to cluster. I need to teach you this one. So there is a three information required: API server, okay, and then two information basically, and certificates, okay. These certificates and all I will talk about later. I don't want to you to you know complicate so badly in the theoretical part itself, so you will get lost. So certificate and all I'll create in RVAC session, but for time being is certificate and token. How to log into the cluster, API server and certificate. Okay, that's all. Authentication, this is called authentication. So here what I'm going to do here, in the config file, you have a cluster. Clusters. CLUSTURNS, clusters. Okay, so you have a clusters here. And then cluster 1, cluster 2, cluster 3 like this. So 1 cluster, 2 cluster, 3 cluster like this. Now here you will have IP address HTTP, IP and port of API server. This is the 1 IP address. This is the 2 IP address, 3 cluster. Now the question is, this API server, you got it. So here you got the three clusters specified in the stanza, which is called clusters. Okay, this is the YAML file, by the way. So config file, you have a content. Now how do you specify the user authentications? Then we have a second section, which we call it users. Okay, in the users we have, and then we say user 1, user 2, user 3, and this is the 3. Now we have a certificate, client keys and certificate, client key and certificate for which server, each server different client key and certificate. Now the problem for me is which user belong to which cluster. Are you getting in the confusion? How do you match this? Because one place you wrote all the clusters which you are currently working, and one place you wrote all the users which currently working, but how do you match this, which user is a part of the which cluster? Are you getting the confusion here? Everyone? Hello? So guys, for that,
yes.
For that matching, we have one called contexts. Yes. So here what we'll do, we'll write a context. Context 1 is equal to cluster 1 plus user 3. This is a mapping. So cluster 2 will have user 2, cluster 2, user 2. This is a mapping. Cluster 3 will have a cluster 3, user 1. So this is the mapping. Now did you understand that, how do you manage the multiple clusters from one file? Did you understand that?
Yes.
But the next, yes. Next problem is, guys, how do you know which currently cluster I am sending a command to? Because one at a time, you can send a instruction only to one cluster at a time. So how do you do that? And for that, we have a new section which is called current context. Context is equal to, it can be one default or two or three. So guys, this is your config file. Using that, kubectl connected to the API server. Understood this? All of you?
Yes.
So guys, can you please read this? If you really understood, can you please read this and tell me what exactly is happening? only the selected one, don't read everything else. I will slowly explain it to you. Have you understood or do I need to explain? Tell me.
Understood.
Everyone? Everyone?
Yes.
Okay. So basically, guys, what I am doing, you know, I am copying this file which has all the entry of config file, and I am making, you know, instead of two machine, one machine and two machine, this same machine I am making the agent, workstation, same machine. Why? Because if I will be in a cluster, during the demo you will feel good. So let me do that in the same machine, okay? Any machines can become a cluster. So here, duplicate, CentOS, as a regular user, okay? As a regular user, see here, regular user. You can be a root user, you can follow this one, but I'm doing as a regular user. So can we do this? That's the reason I said, if you forgot this, it will be very difficult for you. So I created directory, copy this content from there to here, and then here, and this one is change the permission. That's all. This I'm doing as a CentOS user. Okay. And now my workstation is also set up. Now you want to know the content of this? Look at this content of this. There's a permission issues. You can look at your content actually, which I copied. Sudo mess more. See here. This is the clusters. Cluster 1. See IP address. Name of the cluster. Here context. Context, name of the context, 1. Here you have a current context, which is here, and then below you have user. See, users, user, 1 name. Same, it's matching. You see here, clusters, users, contexts, current context. So my workstation is also ready now. Did you understand that? Did you understand that?
Yes. Rajesh, a question here. So how do we switch between the context?
There is a command line also to switch between. Kubectl config is a command line. You can switch the context. Okay. Okay guys, so master is set up, workstation is set up. Can we verify? Now I am using workstation to verify. So kubectl is a command I'll write, and kubectl is a command, cluster info, kubectl cluster info. See, all the commands should be running from the workstation. See here. Master is running at this, which is API server. Kube DNS is running at this. Got it? Any questions, guys? See here, kubectl, get nodes, only master is there. Got it? Any questions?
Yes.
Okay. Now you see, when I do the get nodes, it says not ready. Why not ready? Why not ready? Get nodes, which says not ready. So I can troubleshoot nodes, but right now this is not right time to troubleshoot. But I'll tell you, pod network runs on the pod network. Pods runs on the pod network. And network, pod networking driver is missing. So can you please read this statement? Now, only the one which I selected. Got it, guys? So you have to apply this networking YAML. So if you go to this URL, there is a multiple drivers which fulfill the requirement of Kubernetes networking requirement. Multiple drivers are there. We call it policy, network policy. So here you have ACI, Calico, Canel, Selenium, Genie, Quantif, so many are there. See, so many networking policies are there. One of the policies which I will be trying now today is Calico. So here I am installing the Calico. This command, it's in here, you see here, pod networking. Okay, so after the setup, after doing this, get nodes, pod networking. So can I copy this whole URL? And so I'm applying the pod networking. I'll just copy this, clear the screen, apply it. Now you see here, get nodes, it's not ready. I will watch it till it get ready. It takes some time. See, got ready. So my master is ready, your workstation is ready, networking, pod networking, you installed it. And then last thing, this is the last command for worker. You have to add a worker, right? So before adding worker, I want to show you all the pod. So guys, kubectl get pods hyphen hyphen all namespaces. Kubectl get pod namespaces. See here, look at this, API server pod, etcd pod, controller manager pod, scheduler pod, proxy one node, code DNS, this is the discovery service pod, and just now I installed the weavenet driver pod. See, one by one means one container. 2x2 means this pod has a 2 container. Got it? All these are running state. Got it, guys? Any question?
Rajesh, which is the daemon service it is here?
So you see here, ps-eaf grep docker, see docker d. See here, docker d. This is for container. Kubelet also, you see that. ps-eaf grep kubelet. See, it's running kubelet here. See, got it?
You told that there are two, three ways of deploying a pod, right? Registry, and there are others, deployment and one more, right? So when you deployed the network driver, you did apply on some YAML file, right?
Mm-hmm.
So what kind of deployment is that?
That is a good question. But for that, you have to wait till third day. Because I can explain it to you now, okay. But you will not...
Fine.
Yeah. You will not understand. Because let me show you the output at least. Because you ask that questions, you should have little bit this. I rerun those command again. See here. Do you know service account? No. Cluster role? No. Cluster role binding? No. Role? No. Role binding? No. Daemon set? No. In short, none of these we know, but it has done something. But what is this? This is an API object. Something similar we had pod, replication controller, deployment. So as I said, remember, we had so many APIs and we have to spend next 5 days only to learn those APIs object. That's all. That's the work we have. We don't have anything else. So this is a basically RBAC. These all are RBAC. And this is a pod. This will create a pod. Now, I'll need to discuss on this little bit later. Means day after tomorrow or something. Okay? Okay, guys. So now my cluster is ready. Worker is not ready. Okay? So worker, I need to get it up and running. And can I add the worker now? Can I add the worker now? Any questions? Any questions, guys? Hello? Guys, are you not able to hear me? Did I lost the connection? Okay.
No questions, Radish.
Okay. So now I'm going to set it up one worker. For that, I need a new VM. Before that, I want to show you. See here. Set up a nodes. In the node, aka worker. Follow 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, not 8. Do not follow 8, this one. Okay, do not follow 9. Do not follow 10, like that. So here, 7, and after that run this one. Which is, don't run this command, will not work, because I have got my own, which is here. So here, I don't have to follow entire 7 because of a VM. I have to install the Docker. I have to first install the Docker, then this, then this, then this. Do not this. Again, I repeat, do not do this blindly. So let me install the Docker first. First, I'll get me the instance. CentOS, Marketplace, creating one worker. One CPU, 2 GB RAM is sufficient. Storage, 30 GB, sufficient. Here, name, what? Worker, this is Rajesh. Security group, default, no. Firewall, launch. Rajesh Mumbai. Here it is. View instance. This is the IP address. This is the worker I am setting up, guys. Worker. In the worker also you need Docker. So first I am login. You need everything in worker also. Every setup will be same except init. Don't run init. You run join. Here, restart the session. I'm just trying to access this worker machine. Yes, CentOS setting color. Sudo hyphen s. First, I'll have to install the Docker, which is here. Same thing I'm doing. And then this one. And then this one. Installing this C edition. And then enable it and start it. So Docker is done. Till start only you need it. Then come to here, follow this, clear the screen. And set in 40, same thing, install all the tools,
enable the kubelet. Do not run init. Again I repeat, do not run init in the worker. You have to run join, which is here. So copy this and paste it. Enter. And guys, you see, go to the worker workstation and type get nodes. Session got timed out. Duplicate. This is the workstation. Kubectl get nodes. Not ready. It'll be ready in few seconds because networking pod is being installed. It takes few seconds. I'm watching. Done, guys. So now you see that all three component, workstation, master and worker, we set it up. Everything is okay. So any questions, guys, so far? Any questions? Anyone? Hello? Guys, can you hear me?
Rajesh, can you tell about this namespace you told, no, that we have a different namespaces?
No, I have not discussed so far namespaces. Only I am setting up the cluster, so I'll tell you. I'll teach you.
Okay.
That command I run all namespaces, but I did not explain you what is a namespace, why do we need it, and stuff like that. More questions, guys? Okay, so can we do the quick check of pulses? How many of you are here? So if you are here, just type here in the chat box. Okay, so I believe there is no questions. Okay, so guys, this is the setup. You have to also do that. Now you have to do it for yourself. So again, I'm repeating that you have to set up a master, you have to set up a worker, you have to set up a workstation. What I did and you will do, master and workstation you set up in the same machine but different user ID. Master you set up with the root, workstation you set up with the normal CentOS. First you have to install the Docker, which you have a URL here. Then you have to install it, the master. For the worker, you need everything except init, and here added join. Now this do not copy in mine, because if you run my command, it will get your machine get added to my master, because we all are in the same network, you will be in the lab environment. Okay?
Please enroll our general membership for $399 plan to get access of all the parts.
Along with that, you can access our other tutorials such as Docker, Ansible, Jenkins, Terraform, Splunk, AWS, Azure, and various other DevOps related premium tutorials with our channel membership. If you would have any issues with our channel membership, you can drop an email to us at contact@devopschool.com, or you can also unsubscribe from channel membership anytime if you don't want to continue or did not like the video. To get our channel membership, click on to the join button, select the $399 plan and grow your skills immensely.
Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries. We will reply to them at the earliest.
Thanks for watching.